إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال تعالى يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا وقال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار الحمد لله Indeed all praise is due to Allah We praise Him and we seek His help and forgiveness We seek refuge in Allah from our soul's evils and our wrongdoings He whom Allah guides, no one can misguide And he whom Allah leaves to be led astray, no one can guide. I bear witness that there's no deity worthy of being worshipped except one Allah alone without any partners. And I bear witness that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is his servant and messenger. My dear respected brothers and sisters, Alhamdulillah, it is once again the day of Friday. And we are in the UK in the third week of lockdown 2.0. I pray you are all well, healthy and fit and in the best of Iman. And I want to take this opportunity once again to remind all of you to have a positive mindset in this time of doom and gloom, where many people are cursing the current situation, the issues around the pandemic. We need to remember and say Alhamdulillah for all the blessings that Allah has given us in our life. It is important for us as Muslims, as believers, as people who believe in La ilaha illallah, to have positive thoughts about Allah, to be patient with the decree of Allah. And Allah mentions in a very beautiful verse of the Quran in Surah At-Taghabun, مَا أَصَابَ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَمَن يُؤْمِن بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهُ وَاللَّهُ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عَلِيمٍ Allah mentions here that no disaster, no calamity, no trial, hardship or difficulty, it strikes you except by the permission of Allah. Whether you're having social problems, financial problems, family problems, problems in the community, problems at home, Allah says nothing, no disaster, no calamity, no test, no trial, no tribulation will come to you except with the permission of Allah. And whoever believes in Allah, Allah will guide his heart. And this is something which is very important because during times of test and trial, we believe in Allah. But depending on our faith in Allah, when the trial takes place, sometimes our iman, it fluctuates and it comes down to a low level. And we start questioning the decree of Allah. Why did Allah do this? Why did Allah not have mercy upon me? I remember a time when a lady, her husband passed away. The lady's husband passed away and her mother-in-law was still alive in a very old age. And she said in her anger that why did Allah take my husband away? He should have taken the mother-in-law away first. La ilaha illallah. We pray that Allah forgives her for such comments. But we see from this that Allah has the ultimate wisdom. Allah is the one who knows the seen. Allah is the one who knows the unseen. And Allah says in this verse, Wallahu bi kulli shay'in alim. Allah is knowing of all things. Allah is knowing for you what is good for you in your life, in this world and the akhirah. And also in another verse of the Quran in Surah At-Tawbah, Allah mentions, قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا هُوَ مَوْلَانَا وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ This verse of the Quran was revealed during the time the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was making preparations for the Battle of Tabuk. And it was usually a sunnah, a pattern of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, that he didn't make the companions aware of the military expedition until the time was right. But this situation was different because it was a very long journey. It was a fierce opponent. And it was required that the companions, they make their preparations for this great journey. And from this preparation, we see also while the companions, they went out to make their preparation in Medina, it was also the harvest season. And the dates were ready to be picked off the branches of the trees. This is the time of the harvest in Medina. So we see it was a testing time for a person who had to prepare mentally, physically, spiritually, going in the way of Allah with the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, or staying back in Medina. And here we see the people who did stay behind in Medina, they were either very old people or they were people who were known for being hypocrites. They had signs of hypocrisy in them. So we see all of the people, they put their trust, their reliance in Allah. Allah mentions in this verse, never will we be struck except by what Allah has decreed for us. He is our Mawla. He is our protector. هو مولانا وعلى الله فليتوكل المؤمنون. That Allah is our protector, and upon Allah, let the believers put their trust and rely in Allah. So from this, we understand that Allah is our protector, and a protector is somebody who wants to save you from harm. A protector is someone who has your best interests at hand. And sometimes when we are in testing situations, we don't understand the wisdom behind why Allah has put us in such a situation, or why Allah has decreed something for us. And we start to make sometimes comments which will be displeasing to Allah. It reminds me of the story of Musa and Khidr alayhi salam, when Musa was asked by his people that who is the most knowledgeable person in the world. And he mentioned that it was him, having thought that he speaks directly with Allah, he receives revelation from Allah, but Allah informed him that actually there is a servant in this world that knows more than you. So he asked Allah that, can I see this person? I want to learn from him. And we know the story of Musa and Khidr alayhi salam. There were three incidents that took place. The first one was when Khidr alayhi salam, they were given a lift on a ship, and they were taken on board by the owners of the ship, and he scuttled the ship. And Musa alayhi salam challenged him, saying that, why did you do this? You know, they were doing a favor for us. They took us on board without taking any money. They gave us, did a favor on us. They gave us a ride, and you scuttled their ship. And Khidr alayhi salam, each time he reminded him that, did I not remind you that you will not have patience with me? And then he said, forgive me for something that I have forgotten. They went on, they came off the ship, and they were walking near the shores, and Khidr alayhi salam, he kills a young boy. Now, Musa alayhi salam, he was one who stood up for justice in society, and he stood up against any injustice that took place. We know many years before Musa alayhi salam, he stood up for a person who was being oppressed in an argument that took place, and Musa alayhi salam, he punched the other person, and as a result, this person lost his life. So Musa alayhi salam, again, he questions Khidr alayhi salam, and he says that لَقَدْ جِئْتَ شَيْئًا نُكْرًا. What have you done? You have killed a soul, especially a young, innocent child. You have done a deplorable thing. What was the response of Khidr alayhi salam? Did I not tell you that you will never be able to have patience? إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَسْتَطِيعَ مَعِيَ صَبْرًا. And Musa alayhi salam says, if I should ask you about anything after this, then do not keep me as a companion. They carry on. And the third incident occurs where they went into a community. They were looking for hospitality, some food, some refreshments, and they were rejected by the people. At the edge of the city, or somewhere within the city, there was a wall which was about to collapse. And Khidr alayhi salam, he rebuilt the wall. And Musa alayhi salam again was shocked. He said, look, you did this work for free after the treatment that these people gave us. What was the benefit in all of this? Again, Khidr alayhi salam said, now this is the time for us to depart. You could not have patience with me. I will tell you the answer to all of the questions that were asked, that you asked. And he mentioned that in the first incident, there was a king who had set his army, the navy, after all of the ships in the sea, to seize the ships and to use them for himself. And he said when the navy would see the ship, they could see that it's damaged, so it's not fit for being used for the purpose of the navy. And as a result, they did not take the ship. So we caused them less difficulty and hardship because they were able to make repairs to the ship and continue with their livelihood. In the second instance, knowledge was given to Khidr alayhi salam that this boy, he was going to grow up to be an evil person. And therefore, as a result of this, he took the life of this young boy. Again, during this time, Musa alayhi salam is now getting the answers for why certain things. And then finally, the third incident that took place, Musa alayhi salam is told by Khidr alayhi salam that there were some young orphans behind this wall. There was some wealth that their father had left behind. And if this wall was to fall over, it would have been exposed and the people from the city would have taken from this wealth. La ilaha illallah. So Musa alayhi salam, finally he understood the wisdom behind why Khidr alayhi salam had done certain things. And in the Quran, what's quite interesting is that before Allah tells us the story of the interaction of Musa alayhi salam and the special servant of Allah, Allah says, فَوَجَذَا عَبْدًا مِّنْ عِبَادِنَا آتَيْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِّنْ عِنْدِنَا وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّا عِلْمًا. And they found a servant from amongst our servants to whom we had given mercy from us and had taught him from us a certain knowledge, meaning the knowledge of the unseen, la ilaha illallah, in these three situations. And we see here that Allah says, before the knowledge, he says, to whom we had given a mercy. And just think about this, that all of the three things that he did, the actions, they were actually a form of mercy for these people, because he was saving them from a greater difficulty, a greater affliction, a greater calamity. And Allah is saying, by right of him doing these things, these were a rahmah, a mercy for the people, la ilaha illallah, that we had given mercy from us and taught him from us a certain knowledge. So we see here that sometimes when we are stuck in situations, we don't understand the wisdom behind why Allah has tested us in certain ways. He has put us into different situations. Stories like this, they can remind ourselves that Allah knows what we do not know. As Allah mentions in the second juz of the Quran, وَعَسَىٰ أَن تَكْرَهُ شَيْئًا وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. Perhaps you hate a thing and in it there is good for you. Perhaps you're in a situation, in a pandemic, and there is all struggle and misery and it's all looking doom and gloom, but perhaps in it there is good for you. And perhaps you love a thing which is bad for you. Allah knows while you do not know. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah knows everything in this world. La ilaha illallah. And we see when we talk about reliance and tawakkul in Allah, we understand that this is about the relationship between Allah and His servant. When we have tawakkul in our Lord, our problems, our worldly problems, they will not affect us. They will not affect our heart. Our heart, in fact, will be at peace. And these worldly problems, which we thought were huge, big problems, they will shrink. And we will understand and realize and have stronger faith in Allah that nothing is going to happen to us unless Allah has willed it. Allah is indeed our protector. And we see many, many examples we can give. Unfortunately, time does not permit. We see in the case of Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he was tested by the people, he was a man against the whole of the community during that time. And they decided to throw him into the fire. He put his trust and reliance in Allah. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said, he said, Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakil, that Allah is sufficient for me and he is the disposer of all of my affairs. In Surah Al-Mulk, another verse, Allah mentions, قُلْ هُوَ الرَّحْمَنُ آمَنَّا بِهِ وَعَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْنَا فَسَتَعْلَمُونَ مَنْ هُوَ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. Say, he is the most merciful. We have believed in him and upon him we have relied. La ilaha illallah. We see here again, Allah is reminding us that he is Ar-Rahman. We have believed in him and in Allah we put our trust. So brothers and sisters, in conclusion, when we are going through difficult time periods, we need to remind ourselves of all of the blessings that Allah has given us. Alhamdulillah, Allah has given us a home. Alhamdulillah, Allah gave us time to spend with our family members. Alhamdulillah, Allah gave us the religion of Islam. He gave us spare time where we can spend with our family members. And there's many other blessings that we can continue to count and remember that Allah has given us. So during these times, brothers and sisters, we thank Allah. We are grateful to Allah for every situation that we are in. And also, as we move forward, we think and reflect upon any mistakes that we may have made in our life. We seek forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on this blessed day of Friday. We pray that Allah makes our heart strong, strengthens our heart with iman, with tawakkul, with reliance and trust in Him. And we pray that Allah gives us the ability to act upon what has been said. Wa akhiru da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.